out from the grounds or tree and cranes or mesa ones, that means the fast growing organisms. And tropical mushrooms consist of different parts which are in figure. Tropically are different mushrooms. And that is my objective. Mushroom, Amanita cepangina, that is especially found in the Cepang community. First identified in Cepang community of Jugadi in 1992 AD, Thomas and Bandari. And from that Cepang community, that I renamed as the Amanita cepangina. And this is totally expressed in the locally known as the Pura village of, which is the, well, especially deadly poisonous Amanita's group. But Amanita cepangina is wild edible mushroom. Objective, to identify the best nutrient source within the carbon, nitrogen, magnesium, sources of, for the mycelial growth of Amanita cepangina, although it grow on the mycorrhiza. And research hypothesis, there is significant difference in mycelial growth patterns in different nutrients, basal media within the same sources. There may be better new idea for the beneficial commercialization that help for the conservation of this species. Although this species is mycorrhizal, which can't grow in the artificial media or the other habitat. And rationale of this study, wild edible mushrooms are widely consumed in many countries due to their organoleptic properties such as aroma, flavors, and also due to their richness in carbohydrates, fibers, vitamins, as well as different other nutrients. And one population of the Cepang communities, Cepang peoples of the Nepal, depends on Amanita cepangina for sustenance during the certain period of the year. And preference of the Amanita cepangina for consumption by Cepang in comparison to other mushrooms, it has high nutritive and also potential culinary value. And material and methodology. First of all, collection of the species Amanita cepangina from the Udaipur community. That is western part of the northern western part of the Kaligarh municipality of Chittoor districts. Especially in Cepang community, and preservation of the species, identification of the species, and isolation of pure culture of the cepangina, which is especially done in the CDV lab, in different sterilization technique. In laboratory, pure culture form was obtained from the soil culture of the mycelial in PDA media. The pure culture of the Amanita was maintained for further study at plant pathology and microbiology in CDV2. And material and methodology assessment and vegetative growth patterns of the mycelial in different nutrient sources. Effect of nutrient sources, carbon, nitrogen, vitamins, amino acids on mycelial growth patterns with observed in pathology and microbiology laboratory. And statistical analysis for the presentation of the results by tables, graphs, and figures, SPSS version, systems, and Microsoft Excel were used as well as ANOVA test. And result and conclusion, carbon sources, among the different carbon sources, which is present as the dextrose, lactose, sucrose, fructose, maltose, Malvista as well as control. Among the different sources, different carbon sources, optimum growth of the Amanita cepangina was found in the Malvista and control, but minimum in the sucrose. and nitrogen sources, among the different nitrogen sources, optimum growth of the ammonium nitrate is found in sodium nitrate, while the lowest in the ammonium nitrate is shown in the graph. And the, among the different vitamin sources, optimum growth of the ammonium was found in ascorbic acid, while the lowest maximum growth found in the nicotinic acid. Among the amino acids, different amino acids, which is taken in the maximum growth patterns found in the arginine, while the lowest micellar growth was found recorded in the valines. Conclusion. Preferred species of the wild edible mushroom, meat is a tolerable condition, thus the modern semi-artificial cultivation and commercialization of such highly nutritive, wild edible mycorrhizal mushroom species, which are potentially will help not only to conserve the valuable species, but also to maintain the wild habitat. And from the present study, it can be concluded that vegetative growth patterns of a particular mushroom is different in different nutrient sources such as carbon, nitrogen, vitamins, and amino acids. Among the different sources, amino acid as in any the maximum growth patterns. And recommendation, necessity of the proper management of the community forest in order to avoid the extinction of these species. That is, it only grows on the mycorrhizal form in the Soria robusta sal forest, as well as the Sima castrensis forest, the Chelonicotus forest, root mycorrhizal form. And the afforestation strategy of the Soria robusta sal should be emphasized for the conserving their habitat. Semi-artificial cultivation, that is domestication by seedling infection methods for beneficial commercialization. Sustainable utilization of the Soria robusta and Amanita terminiana to fulfill the requirement of the local people and maintain them for future generation. Public awareness programs should be conducted to make the aware of mushroom poisoning and proper identification of the mushroom. Very friends, acknowledgement and thank you.
It is mushroom question. That for only one question. It is represented edible wild mushroom, and in the very last recommendation, he alerted it is poisonous.
Amanita, highly poisonous mushroom. That is body is Amanita phalloides.
Could you please clarify this very debatable question in your presentation? You highlighted edible mushroom in Japan community. They extract it, should be prohibited wild extraction. And in the very last, you recommended, okay, people should be made aware in poisoning by these species. How your study in different nutrient sources relate to this recommendation and real practice in Japan community?
Especially Amanita mushroom species are deadly poisonous. Among them, Amanita cepangina slightly different, and which is first identified from the Chiton Jugedi, already I mentioned. According to the community, the species is named as the Amanita cepangina, and other species, Amanita phalloides, Amanita muscaria, Amanita burma, these are deadly poisonous. And these Amanita cepangina is also the poisoning effect when people which can't liver. And liver is people can digest and get the nutrient. And that is mushroom poisoning is the component present in the mushroom, alkaloids, flavonoids, like chemicals. When the concentration of the chemicals can't digest people, that is the least labored people, is like the urban people.
And this mushroom species, Amanita
cepangina,
is mildly poisonous.
If this species used consumed extensive amount.
Mildly, that means mildly.
Yeah, you have to conclude it. And what you found, you have to deliver real information to the people.
One
question I'd like to that is for the whole public, that we got the news that the people who take the mushroom and they died because of that poisonous mushroom. Is there any technique to differentiate the poisonous and the non-poisonous? That would be helpful if you know that then.
There are different techniques, but there is no fast and hard and fast rules. The species which are the white surface in the head or bilus, that is deadly poisonous, and mushroom which are consist the annulus ring and bulba. These are the deadly poisonous mushroom. They can even touching the species with the finger, that is the poisoning effect.
It is really difficult to distinguish this poisonous mushroom and non-poisonous one. And he will focus this study in Nepal. It is very nifty research, and no PhD scholars. He will get PhD scholarship within this field. This keeps us after 2 weeks.